I mean, if it comes down to you not knowing how to do something specific, you can just Google it.
Yeah.
I mean, like, you can have glasses.
You can have glasses. You can. I mean, I'm a photographer. That's my main focus. Photographer, filmmaker, and I didn't know anything about cameras. I didn't take classes in school or anything. And I took classes online. I Googled stuff and I took tutorials on Vimeo, the film school on Vimeo, and that's how I learned how to use Canons and Nikons, and now I film music videos and I take photos and I make a living out of it. You know, it's my life, and I didn't go to school for it. And then we have a little sister who went to school for 5 years and learned all these things, and she knows a lot of it, but she doesn't make much content. She's kind of
experimental.
She's never, because in her head, she's been told that things need to be very official.
A process.
And there's a process. You gotta go this way. And I almost have to break her out of her school process to think, just play with it. Just grab the camera, go outside, and just make something. You know, because I didn't go to school. I feel like I'm just gonna go and do it. And nobody has to tell me how to do it. I just gotta play. You know, make stuff. You know, you gotta just stand to do it. And I feel like the more you film, and the more you use the cameras, and the more you get invested, and the more content you make, and you start putting it together, then even more important stuff come out of it.
Yeah.
I think the more photos I've taken, and the more stuff I've filmed. Sometimes I'm just, like a whole summer, I'll just film a bunch of stuff, and then I'll just put it together, and I realize that it tells a story, and it's like, oh cool, I'm not gonna tell anybody, I didn't mean to do this, you know? Nobody has to know. It just turns out to be great.
Yeah.
So, you know, just play. Gotta play.
I have a question. When you're working with Quentin Tarantino or Robert Rodriguez, how do you experience them as a director? And you know, what's their drive to make a specific movie? And how? What's their maybe their working method? You know, how do they get by the day?
Quentin really hates working with you. No, but it's just he hates it because every time we're on set,
what do you mean?
Well, he just gets so mad because I'm like, you need to just tell him to. He's like, what? Get away! Like, go! You know, he needs like a water spray bottle to like get me off of him. Because I'm always telling him like what I think he should do.
And so I'm professional.
Or I'll be like, just start directing these actors. And he's like, what the fuck? Get the fuck out of here! No. And he told me one time, he's like, you need to direct. Like, I think it's something you really want to do. You hate when you're in front of the camera and you're telling all the actors what to do. You need to just try it. So it is something that I wanted to do. I guess I was afraid, you know. And especially because we got in the big way. We had the big door to Hollywood. And we're very grateful, very lucky that was our entrance. But that's the studio way. So we kind of got in, even though Robert and Quentin are independent focused filmmakers, we got it.
Well, they still make some pretty blockbuster movies.
But not just that, they're big studio movies. So the studios make you feel like only the studios can make these things happen. And only through the studio system you can be a successful director, and that's not true. So nowadays, I will read a script from literally anybody who sends it to me. If you feel like you should work with me and there is something there you really want to work with me, then I like to read it. I'm not gonna lie, if the script, if I'm holding it and the title doesn't feel right and holding it doesn't feel right, I'll tell you right away, I don't need to read this. But I go by intuition. I'll read something, if I like it, I'll do it, and I think that's you shouldn't judge by who's attached to the script or, you know, who the filmmaker is.
But to answer your question, go on this tangent.
Yeah, you tell
I love working with Quentin.
Okay,
and what I see him as a director is he is an action person. Like, he'll tell you exactly to the detail what he wants. Robert doesn't at all. He'll just,
yeah.
Like, Robert like looks at you and he's like, he just tells him like a couple things very quietly, and like, they'll move lights and things around you, and you're as an actor, like, did he like it? Did he? Like, Quentin's like, no, don't like this, and he'll throw himself on the ground, and he'll like become the character that he wants to do, and you're like,
Okay, so this is the thing. Quentin has, you know how everybody has a personal bubble?
Yeah.
Everybody has a personal space. Okay, Quentin's is bigger than most people. So what happens is when he's talking to you, you know, real close, he's like, oh my god, this is what you're gonna do. Like, and you're like, oh my god, you're gonna kiss me. I can see the back of your teeth. Like, the people
actors are like, oh my god, like, it's what Tarantino, like, yeah, you're a little bit, you know, whatever. But their guys are like, okay, I mean, immediately,
and he's so tall,
and he tells you, he's gonna cross his boundary and your boundary, I guess.
But a lot of them are just, anyway,
he does.
The difference between the two, and they complement each other really well. They're really good friends, you know, Robert and Quentin. So when Robert is not very animated, even though when he talks and when he films, he's very animated and excited. He gets really excited. But when he's filming, he's very like, and when he goes, moving on, you're like,
and then like 200 people are moving the whole set.
Yeah, and you're like, what are we doing? And you know, the DP will be like, you did great, you loved it. I'm like,
yeah, the DP is the one always just telling people.
Or the first AD.
Brian,
they didn't want to do it in like years.
So he asked a good question. I went to the same film school as Robert Rodriguez at the University of Texas. And they always told us that Robert, on a very simple budget, could make an amazing film. And it wasn't because necessarily he was a decent negotiator or a businessman. It really had to do with building a team, both from production to talent, that each person was the best that they could be. And that's why you see his movies, like Machete Kills just came out, that is made in very little days on a low budget. So you being around that atmosphere, what would you say is the best part about all these talented people on the sets that he's able to make these films short and sweet?
Well, he knows good budgeting. Good budgeting, but also the family. They've been working together for years. There's a trust. He filters people really quickly. If he knows, if people make specific mistakes, he knows that he doesn't even waste time in giving second chances to people, which is kind of crappy, but it's just the way that he works. And for years, he's worked with the same team. Closer, you know, specifically the ones that have the bigger jobs, his lighting crew, his camera crew, everybody. It's like, these people work together, and they've been working together for the last 15 years, 20 years.
And he's helped people rise. So I think that's the secret, and what I've learned, also producing movies, is even when I first started, when people were like, I'll do it for free, you know, and I've had that attitude too, I'll do it for free. Like, don't do anything for free. Free doesn't work. Free makes you feel like you didn't gain anything. Like you may have not really gained.
But so
it doesn't have to be money. It has to be something that makes you feel like you were worth your time, you know? Even though you love what you did, even though you love being a part of it, getting paid something.
There needs to be an incentive, because then you don't invest all that you can, and you're not excited to put more into it, which the project will need. It will need for it to move forward, for it to be, you know, sent out and make money, if that's what you want. But more than anything, you gotta exchange something. There needs to be some kind of exchange. The way that Robert does it, he has tricks from the movie or from El Mariachi. He still does the same tricks in his $1 million, the films. And it has to do with that mentality of, I only have $7,000.
Yeah.
And so I'm gonna make the best I can with little tricks. And he does that with $1 million, like millions and millions of dollars he has for the movies. And so he has these tricks in which he moves about, and then he can make movies that look like giant blockbuster movies in like 3 months, and you're like, how can you do it? And he's like,
For 30 days.
He can just like, it's like putting bread in the oven for him.
So I think the secret with him is budgeting. He budgets, he has a producer that budgets well, and
understands his process.
Yeah, he respects that budget. And the actors, he works with actors who want to work with him. I remember when he was casting Sin City, so many actors came out of the woodwork. Actors, I couldn't believe it. I'm not going to mention names because there are cameras on. But there were so many big actors that I mean, I was stunned, like, super huge known actors that wanted to do this BNC City for nothing, basically, like, just wanted to do it. And Robert had to really sit down and look at, okay, who do I really want to work with, really wants to be a part of this, and it's going to be great being a part of this project and carrying out his vision. And then there were some who he really wanted to work with, but they were like, no, I won't do it for less than whatever, whatever. And Robert's like, well, this is what I don't budge, you know? So you have to really, you know, think about it, but I think that's the secret, knowing your budget and respecting the budget.
So that's another difference between Quentin and Robert.
Yeah.
Quentin doesn't respect the budget.
Quentin doesn't care about time, doesn't care about budget. He will film a movie for a year.
Yeah.
I mean, Inglourious Basterds. Django. Django, I mean, a journey of a movie. I'd take my hat off for that.
Yeah.
And he won an Oscar for it. The movie won. I mean, I love that movie. And to be completely honest with you, I respect Quentin for not necessarily sticking to the budget or the time, because sometimes the integrity of the project needs that. And Django deserves all the time and all the craziness and all the problems, headaches, and investment that that man put into it. He is obsessed with his projects.
Yeah.
So obsessed that he doesn't care if people get fired for it, if people get upset and they never talk to him again. He doesn't care if he loses his family over it. He's just like,
oh,
I'm just gonna feel, no, like the family, that the crew, you know? His fucking crew. Like,
yeah.
Sometimes he loses people that he's been working for years, and they're like, I can't do this anymore. He's like, well, you can't do it anymore? Somebody else will.
Yeah.
I'm going to turn team.
But that, it's not just that, it's, he has a vision. And that's why he is who he is, you know? You have to carry out your vision as a personal artist. You can't let anybody destroy your vision, you know?
Yeah.
And so stick to your integrity. That's number one. Stick to your integrity, and if you have a budget, stick to your budget. But if the budget is another obstacle to your integrity, get the fuck out. Your integrity must first.